right. We are minutes away from the PlayStation Showcase. Thank you so much for joining me. Hope you're all having a great day. It's going to be a lot of fun. It's going to be about a 40-minute presentation, they said. And there's going to be no news on the next iteration of PlayStation VR, so it's not going to make an appearance. No footage, no source of news whatsoever. But what we are in for is, I'm sure, a lineup of games that are going to blow us all away. And it's also going to showcase the future of the PlayStation 5 generation. So, I love my PlayStation 5. I came dressed for the occasion. I'm ready to go. I've got the buttons on my sleeves. Let's go. It comes with a hood too, but it doesn't fit well when I have my headphones on. So, I'm just going to leave it down. Terrence is sticking around, though. We're enjoying some Fortnite. We actually got a couple wins. If you missed us playing Fortnite earlier, a lot of fun. We're also completing some of the final legendary quests for Season 7 because it ends on Sunday. Operation Skyfire. All right, folks, we are like seconds away. I'm looking at my clock. All right, it's 4 o'clock. It should be starting like literally any second now, so this is going to be really exciting. I'm also not going to talk like during the trailers excessively, but I will make little comments here, and I invite everyone to join in the chat as well. Don't be shy, I won't bite. But if you'd rather just lurk in the background, hey, that's totally cool with me too. All right, let's do this. The anticipation is like, killing me. It's an exciting time to be a gamer. Little bit over. That's okay. That usually happens. I love how it's focusing on Terrence and not me. I'm out of focus. All right, here we go, folks. Showtime. Enjoy the show. Mature content. God of War. Okay, I think I know what this is. I think it's just like a trailer for like PlayStation Studios in general. I think this is the same song that they used in the Wonder Woman 1984 trailer. Like 99% certain. Sounds like it. I've been fooled before, though. Oh yeah, it totally is. It's a great song. It's got a great beat to it.
Welcome to country.
love everything about this trailer. It's really cool. I don't know if it's like a game or... I mean, I hope it is, because I'm here for it. That looks really cool. But again, I think it's just like a trailer for PlayStation Studios. Yeah. Still really cool. I love the whole chess concept. It's really, really nice. All right. So what'd you guys think of that trailer? Let me know in the chat. All right, let's get it.
I'm Jim Ryan, President and CEO of Sony Interactive Entertainment, and welcome to the PlayStation Showcase. At PlayStation, we believe in pushing boundaries and setting the benchmark for creativity and excellence in entertainment.
I love the DualSense.
We always love the opportunity to speak
directly
with our community.
It's a really comfortable controller.
The new technology in PS5 enables development teams to build more exciting, immersive, and compelling worlds, showcasing their creative vision as storytellers.
Ratchet and Clank is probably going to be my game of the year for 2021.
So thank you for allowing us time to share some significant updates and brand new content. So without further ado, let's look at some new and amazing games.
I'm ready, let's go. Oh, here we go. We got Star Wars.
Peace is a lie. That is what the Sith believe. They promise power. Now they wield it. We face the greatest Sith in generations. They must be stopped.
No freaking way! Oh my god! Knights of the Old Republic! Oh, no way. And they're opening with that. Oh, let's go. Let's get some hype in the chat, folks. Can you believe that? I wonder if that's exclusive. Oh, I'm here for it. Let's go. Okay, well, we're getting some some interesting close-up shots there. All right. What is that? Final Fantasy? It looks beautiful. I'm guessing it's like a Final Fantasy game. I mean, whatever it is, JRPGs aren't really my thing. But I know someone right now is freaking out. This doesn't look like a Final Fantasy game, though. Like, seeing combat?
Yeah,
Again, JRPGs aren't my forte, so... I mean, it looks breathtaking. It really does. Yeah, these guys look pretty cool. Again, I don't know what it is. Love the music. For all I know, this could be an entirely new series. Project Well, all right, that was pretty cool. Oh, here we go.
Darkness washes over the land.
This is Tiny Tina's Wonderland.
The Dragon Lord.
The showcase is at
E3. Has returned!
Fools! Your party of heroes can't stop me!
Who's ready to rickety roleplay? Spoiler? It's you, baby.
I love the Borderlands series, so I am totally here for this. Of guns. I love it. Oh my god, that's hilarious.
Where are there guns in a fantasy world? And I am just so glad you asked, because shut up your face and get shooting!
This is pure Borderlands. Yeah, this is going to be a lot of fun, you know, Friday, Saturday nights. Squatting up with your friends. We got like orcs and, oh, unicorns. Okay, I'm in.
I'm in.
You ready, newbie?
I felt like she was throwing that right at me, so I had to grab it.
All right, trailer over.
March 25th, 2022. Okay, I thought they were going to show a little teaser for the Borderlands movie, but I guess not. These transitions are really cool. I like them. Alright, we got Square Enix.
I'll let you in on a secret, but I'm a pretty big deal. Real big deal. We are getting out of the city, Homer. I promise we'll go somewhere that loves cats.
Oh, that cat looks so real.
No more fights. Clean air. Bright skies. What the actual fuck?
Okay, well, this looks cool.
Asuka.
Who's there?
And technically not Earth. Well, not what you would call Earth, anyway.
I swear to God, asshole, show yourself.
Show myself? I've shown.
Where are you?
Right here, at the end of your arm.
Was that,
Hello, yes.
Oh, what's his name?
Okay, so let me get this
Stephen
straight.
Merchant.
I'm somewhere that's not what I would call Earth. I'm seeing a freaking dragon, and, oh yeah, I'm talking to a cop. Did I just do that?
We did.
I just moved shit.
That sounds like him.
Yeah, okay, that is something I do now. I do magic, kill jacked up beasts, I'll probably fly next.
No, you're just being ridiculous.
Oh, that's too far. Good to know there's a line.
I don't know what this is, but I'm here for it.
Suffers. You are the only hope we have. You're special.
You're the one that's planning on facing off with Syla. Tanta Syla is the strongest and most formidable of all the Tantas. You will be doing our land a great service by killing her.
Spoken. Okay.
Frey. No name for a demon.
I am the one you seek. The one and only Tanta Syla.
Alright. Spring 2022, so we won't have to wait too long for that one. And that's interesting, because not only does it have a female protagonist, also has a female antagonist, and we don't get a lot of that too often, so I'm here for it.
Biological weapons.
Let me know in the chat what you thought of that one.
But now, we face the greatest terror our world has ever known.
Oh, nice. Rainbow Six Extraction. This one looks really cool. Although those things freak me out, but if I have a squad that can like carry me, I'll be happy. This would be a great game to play with friends as well.
If we want a shot at tomorrow, we will move as one. We will think as one. We will do whatever it takes. As one. Together, we enter the unknown. Together, we fight for our future. And no one will be left behind.
January 2022. We're buffering. Oh, there we go. We're good. Right. What do you think, folks? So far, we're at the halfway point. Epic Games Publishing. All right. Oh, yes!
Coming for me.
Alan Wake!
Whatever you do, don't go out.
Let's go!
Stay in the light.
The Deerfest guests have already...
If you've never played this game before, you're in for a treat. It's like one of the best games ever. I'm not even kidding.
Alice?
And it's on PlayStation for the first time, because originally when it came out
last night, I woke up to
on Xbox 360, it was exclusive to that.
What had happened to me? I squeezed the flashlight like my life depended on it. With it, I could save myself.
I have the collector's edition for this game, and it comes in like this giant book, because Alan Wake is an author. So
Carl Stucky,
pleased to meet you. It's a lot of fun. The way it's presented is cool as well. It's almost like a television series. So each new level that you play, or when you come back to the game, you get a sort of, you get a recap of everything that you've done. Awesome. Available October 5th. That's like right around the corner. All right. I'm getting that one too. Oh boy. We're getting another version of Grand Theft Auto 5. Oh boy. This in Skyrim.
I gotta run now, okay?
Alright, bye babe.
It's lonely up here.
Thoroughly enjoyed this one. My favorite Grand Theft Auto game.
Get us out of here!
Because there was just so much to do.
I think we're gonna literally make out like bandits on this.
I didn't really play the online too much. Maybe I'll jump back into that. Maybe we'll stream that one day. Let me know in the chat if you think that would be cool. Oh wow, that was unfortunate. March 2022. So not much longer for that one either. Like Slender Man.
Critical work. People always decry the truth when forced to face it. Still your fear. I will be her salvation.
Mari.
Oh. That's unfortunate.
The time is nigh. The world rests on the precipice of transformation. A new age will dawn.
Ghostwire Tokyo. Looks pretty cool. They've shown that before, or at least they've teased it in a previous presentation, and it looked really cool. So I'm glad we got to see a little bit more footage. Oh, we got something for Marvel.
Guardians of the Galaxy.
Ooh, Guardians of the Galaxy.
You came here seeking truth. The matriarch wishes to share it with you. United in the light of belief, all suffering, all grief will end. Oh! Yeah!
What's wrong with you? Oh, I think. Yeah, I think I'm having a heart attack.
Cease this at once. Fine.
Cosmo! How you doing, buddy?
Grand Unifier Anchor, leader of the Church of Truths.
During that ritual with the priest, they kept talking about a promise.
It was like they were drinking funky juice or something.
We're joining the cult.
So let us investigate for you.
Always a catch, Peter Quill. And not fun kind with Bo.
Hey, world mind. Long time no see.
The current probability of defeating
the Universal Church of Truth is
0.3%.
Is that bad? It sounds bad.
It is.
I mean, it's not zero, so there's still a chance. Leader.
That makes two of us.
So it looks like we'll get some space combat.
By rejecting the promise, you have proven yourselves unworthy, and you must be destroyed.
Let's go.
That was completely intentional. The Milano's on her way. Thanks, bud.
October 26th. Just in time for Halloween. Vampire the Masquerade, Blood Hunt. Okay. My guess is it's probably going to be November.
Welcome to the Eon Program. Picture your perfect you.
Oh, this is Deathloop.
Your health, your enlightenment, your... We offer eternity.
Shut up.
Your esteemed visionaries believe the only
thing. I'm excited for this one.
The visionaries. Eight geniuses who painted up a prison and named it Freedom. Locked us all in one repeating day. Their eternity. An endless party that you can never leave.
I am a storm.
So we only have a couple more minutes, about 13 minutes left.
Supposed to be unforgettable.
Still plenty of time to showcase a lot of great stuff.
Science nerds, brainwashed cultists flinging bombs. Whatever.
Personally, I think we've been really spoiled so far.
Bullshit.
Especially with, I mean, coming right out of the gate.
How come I don't remember shit?
With Knights of the Old Republic remastered. I mean, come on.
Is answered.
Like,
who are these people?
That's
what do
incredible.
They want with me? And why is she always one step
I'm,
ahead?
I'm
come on, Cole.
I'm speechless.
You gotta put this together. Somebody built this place. Somebody's sending me these messages.
I want to know in the chat, what is your favorite
whenever
announcements
and some
so far?
Let
me know.
Plan out here. Is this a contest?
What are you still hoping for? What's on your wish list?
How does this time loop?
Don't be shy.
Does anybody remember?
Why is everyone wearing a mask?
Right.
What the hell is
black man's notes anymore?
Who am I?
Colt, I want you to remember. I want you to remember why you came here.
Huh. Is that... Damn, I look good.
You know what? I say that every morning.
I've imagined myself.
I wake up and
out.
I look in the mirror. What I say.
I'll
break this time loop before it breaks me.
Oh, what do we got here? I don't know if I should be scared or... Kid Amnesia, I think it was. It's in collaboration with Epic Games, so. Well, this looks cute. Doing a Super Mario Odyssey. Oh, you can become a turtle. She's got a flower on her head. That's cute. Game inspired by... I missed what that said. This looks cute though. I'm all about the cute games. Alright, we got about... Started a little bit late, so I'm gonna say a solid 10 minutes left. Let's see what else we have coming down the pipeline.
The biggest pirate treasure of all time is within our...
Oh, place. No way!
The Tusk of Ganesh? That's not an easy find.
Is this all the Uncharted games coming to PS5? Or is it just Last Thieves End and Lost Legacy?
Thieves digging around where we shouldn't.
Either way, I'm excited.
Hang on!
Oh, crap!
Looks like it's just Thieves End and Lost Legacy, treasure. But I don't care. I'm here for it. If they announce, oh, so there's no release date on that, nothing. It's just, it's coming soon.
I'm Herman Hulst, head of PlayStation Studios. PlayStation Studios, at its heart, is a diverse and passionate group of storytellers at our collective of AAA studios all across the globe. Everything we do is driven and inspired by storytelling. As creators, PlayStation 5 gives us the opportunity to push the boundaries of storytelling even further. Our world-class development teams at PlayStation Studios have already delivered such incredible gaming experiences for PS5, and we're only just getting started. As you'll see today with the lineup of exclusive games coming for PlayStation Studios, we're going to continue to drive innovation, advance gaming, while always embracing the legacy of PlayStation and creating games that matter, games that you're not going to find anywhere else. Enjoy.
Awesome. Translation, lightning round. So I think we're going to see game after game right here. Insomniac Games. Oh, come on. Oh, let's go. Is this guy Wolverine? He's Wolverine. Come on. Oh! No way! Oh, yes! Here we go! Oh, if they throw like Spider-Man, I'm like... I'm gonna pass out from too much excitement. Oh, this is probably Gran Turismo. What are they up to now? Six? Like six or seven, I think. Although they could just take out the numbers altogether and call it Gran Turismo, right? Kind of like starting fresh. The one thing I love about racing games is how beautiful they look. Like all the ray tracing, like look at that. That looks like it's in my garage right now. Trust me, it's not. But it looks like it. I haven't played any of the Gran Turismo games because I've mostly been... I'm a Forza kind of guy, but... I mean, I might have to... pick this one up. You know, just to have... Oh, it's got photo mode. Sold. Oh, that's crazy! You can, like, place your cars and stuff. Oh. Let's go. Let's get it. About one thing, when it comes to showcasing a racing game, it's just footage of cars, right? It's like, okay, we get it. It's a racing game. It looks beautiful. So it's always a matter of how can we make this look really interesting and enticing to play. Lots of close-ups. Oh, there we go. Seven. Okay, I might have to pick it up. So that looks like a lot of fun. All right, what do we got?
For as long as I can remember, I have looked for an equal. One who could push me.
No way!
One who could surprise me.
Oh, is this like Electro?
One who could even beat me. Yet all I found is disappointment.
Oh, who is it?
Finally give me what I desire.
Anticipation.
Yes. We will.
No! Oh! Yes! Spider-Man 2. I'm blowing out my audio, but I do not care. Oh, 2023! No! You cannot do that to us! Oh! I knocked Terrence over. Terrence, I apologize. I was so excited by that announcement! Oh, jeez. Come on, give me a second to recover here. Oh, yes! Oh, PlayStation isn't holding any punches. They're just coming out with announcement after announcement now.
Time is running out. The prophecies say Fimbulwinter leads to Ragnarok. War is coming. My story doesn't end hiding in these woods. I should be out there, finding out who I am, who Loki is.
I will not allow you to pick a fight with God.
I don't want to fight anyone. I just want answers.
And if those answers lead to war with Asgard?
Maybe that's what Mother wanted.
We do not know what Mother wanted.
Well, I recognize that dour expression anywhere.
Oh boy. I don't know if my heart can take anything else.
What if there was someone who could help us?
This is incredible. We are truly spoiled.
The old god of war in these lands, who is dead.
Well, for a dead man, Odin seemed pretty keen on seeing he wasn't found.
If he's out there, we gotta find him.
Come in. What in all yarns be the happen to him?
We're trying to stop Ragnarok, to help people. And what if the only way to do that is war?
So now I wonder, is it going to be called God of War right now?
War.
Or is it going to change it to something else?
Stop thinking like a father for a moment and start thinking like a general.
No. You seem like a calm and reasonable person. Are you a calm and reasonable person?
Oh, snap. Here comes Thor.
In moments of crisis, panic is nothing. Harness it.
I bet you they're gonna end with this. This is how it ends. Because literally, my heart can't take anything more, PlayStation. Please, no more announcements. It's officially called God of War Ragnarok. Let's get some hype in the chat.
Well, some of them.
Wow. Holy cow. More updates. Folks, I don't know if I can take any more. Oh, here they come. Oh, it's the presentation that just keeps on giving.
Unbelievable. Yes, yes, inconceivable. See myself as fairly reasonable. But at times I can be stubborn, so if I have to, I will rock the boat. I don't tend to take the easy road. That's just not the way I like to roll. Two things probably unfeasible.
It's dance party now, folks.
It's probable that I might
mess up. Oh, that. Okay.
So
I honestly don't know what I'm more excited about, although I'm 99% sure it's Venom. Like, Spider-Man 2? Let's go. Although Wolverine was awesome. Guardians we knew about. Alan Wake was leaked earlier. Extraction we've known about. Uncharted looks really good. I mean, it's remastered, but I didn't know they were doing that.
Well, I recognize that dour expression anywhere.
Let's go. I think this might be the end of the presentation.
And that was the PlayStation Showcase. We've got more info and updates coming right now. And I'm, in fact, joined by no less than PlayStation Studios head Herman Holst. Herman, really strong showing here from PlayStation Studios tonight, including an awesome new look at GT7 and, finally, a release date.
GT7 is coming in March, and I don't think fans are going to be disappointed with what Yamauchi-san and Polyphony have been working on. And what we're doing with GT7 is we're pulling from the entire history of the franchise, taking some of the best features into GT7. GT campaign, arcade missions, all that good stuff. And, you know, I got a chance to play, and it just looks and plays sensationally. The haptics, the vibrations, you feel the rolls, the pull and the weight of the different cars. I'll tell you,
well, that was exciting, folks. Holy cow.
Is the braking variations through the adaptive triggers.
I mean,
that really kind of makes you feel like you're an incredible racer. And for me, that's
wow.
Great to hear that about GT7. I can't wait to play that. But I also really wanted to talk about Insomniac. I mean, this is a studio that is absolutely
here we go. Let's
on
do
fire
it.
The last year, maybe 18 months, with Marvel Spider-Man, Miles Morales, Ratchet and Clank, A Rift Apart.
Incredible.
And now two big reveals tonight in the form of Marvel's Spider-Man 2 and Marvel's Wolverine. It's kind of a shock. You work really closely with Insomniac.
Let's go. Let's get some hype going in the chat.
Why Insom
Those
gets so
awesome
fired
announcements.
Up about the Marvel Universe?
I mean, Sid, you said it. Insomniac are on fire. They've been just so productive. And I think the team in Insomniac, they're really
I want to know your reactions. Let me know right
raise
now.
The bar with their approach to storytelling and craftsmanship. And it's really evident in the consistently high quality of games that they've been delivering over the years. I think on top of that, they really, really prize collaboration amongst their team. And that collaboration that also extends to the way that they work with other PlayStation teams, but also their work with their great partners at Marvel. And that collaboration resulted in the amazing first two Marvel Spider-Man games. And I know that Insomniac are extremely excited to be further expanding the universe into Marvel Spider-Man 2 now. And they're also going to be raising the bar again, you know, in terms of immersion, action, visual fidelity. I think Marvel Spider-Man 2 will be a spectacular showpiece for gaming. And they're also so thrilled to then bring gamers an emotional and
it
a
would
suspenseful
be really cool
journey into
if,
Marvel's Wolverine. I think
if
that
it's a co-op
PlayStation
game.
Fans are really going to be in for a treat over the next few
One
years.
One person can
very
take
cool,
control of Peter
times.
Parker, the
and,
other
and,
person
and
can play as Miles Morales.
Tonight
you
we
team
also
up to
got
take
our
down
first
Venom. I mean,
big
come
look
on.
At God of War Ragnarok.
That would be
Herman,
incredible.
What can you tell us about where Santa Monica Studio is going with this one?
You know, like many of the fans, I'm personally really, really invested in the relationship between Kratos and Atreus. We got to see in the trailer.
I
want to
know your reactions
so
in the chat right now. Let me know.
Ragnarok approaches, so you know, I can't wait for players to see how that relationship between them evolves. And you gotta trust me when I say that Santa Monica Studio have prepared quite a few twists and turns for players as they set up the finale of the Norse saga in God of War Ragnarok.
We're going to get an update on God of War Ragnarok from Santa Monica Studio here in just a moment. But before you go, Herman, I want to get your take on Horizon Forbidden West. Now, we've learned that this one is coming out in February. I am sure that
pre-orders are
so
open right now.
What has
so
jumped out to you? What can you tell us about the game?
Grab your preferred edition.
The
I got the collector's
PS4
edition.
PS4 and PS5, and it looks great on
so
both.
So it looks...
For PS5,
amazing. It comes
with
a beautiful statue
Aloy,
of a Tremor Tusk.
It's just exceptional. Even more amazing because the environments have so much going on.
It looks really cool.
From the ruins of San Francisco to those new underwater areas, everything just looks breathtaking. And it loads really fast because of the SSD. Plus, the combat in the game offers so much variety.
It's
all based on player choice.
It's a statue
choice.
Of
There's
this
so many
guy
cool
right here.
And tools and when you combine these together, that comes in really handy.
There's also another version, which comes with, like...
On PS5, The haptic feedback.
A little bit more stuff. I think it comes with another statue, but it's painted up a little bit different.
You know, when you're firing arrows and the other ammo.
It's a little bit more too.
I know them so well. I'm super proud of them. They're creating something incredibly special. And I just can't wait for gamers to get the next chapter of Aloy's
top tier version is like 300.
We're joined now by Eric, and then the one below that Santa Monica Studio.
Is,
I wanted to check in with you two
like
on the big announcement.
That's the one that I got
a few minutes ago. God of War Ragnarok.
Naomi Lasagna's here. How's it going, Naomi?
And actually, Eric, I wanted to start with you.
Nice to see you. We've just been watching the PlayStation Showcase.
God of War, including 2018's God
blowing out the audio levels.
Yeah, that's correct. I've been at the studio
on several occasions.
In many different capacities, working with both Santa Monica and
Hope you're having a great day, Naomi. Thanks for stopping by.
I don't know why.
It's always nice seeing you in there.
It's a good idea to say, hey, do you want to direct this one? And so that's what I'm doing. I'm directing God of War Ragnarok, whereas Corey
likes to call it. Let me tell you, I honestly...
So that's...
I don't know what I'm more excited about. I keep saying that, but I keep coming back to Spider-Man 2.
Santa Monica to change the directors across the games. You know,
come on, you have Venom in the game as the villain, like
director, and you know, rightfully so. He's pretty damn good at what he does.
I'm speechless.
The important thing for us is to be able to kind of get a fresh perspective.
But it sucks because it's not coming out
also,
until 2023.
You know, in the sense that you're really exhausted at the end of finishing one.
You know what?
Things.
It's going to be worth it though. I still have Miles Morales to finish.
So Eric, what aesthetics or
all of that
themes
yet?
Sort of resonate with you as a creative? I mean, I guess what I'm
so
getting at
I got
is
a
like,
little
how,
bit
how
of
do you
time.
See yourself leaving your fingerprints on God of War?
Holy cow, though.
That's kind of the designer in me wants to answer one.
Incredible.
As a director,
like
you
said, more so.
I think you have to learn how to jettison your own.
It's going
to
be really interesting
when you
if it's co-op.
Role, which
that
sure
would
Corey
be awesome.
Understand? I mean, he kind of animated a little bit on God of War 2, and we kind of had to throw it all out, except for that sneaky backflip that Kratos has never done again that we left in. That's the perk of being the director, I guess. But you know, from my point of view, like we want to tell a very heartfelt and epic story, as you know, father and son. On a journey, and they kind of struggle with holding on to stuff and letting go of things. You know, it's a very difficult kind of human condition that we all deal with, and we kind of want to arrive at that by taking like slices of life or family, you know, drama, if you will, and kind of juxtapose that against big Norse backdrop. And you know, at the end, we just want to have an ending that feels very, you know, surprising yet inevitable based on all those things. But it's kind of,
okay, so that's,
you know,
gonna be
from
the
Midwest,
to the
so
Norse
like slice of life, very common mundane things are just as interesting as
Norse
big
mythology storylines.
So we try to collide those things together. It's, you know,
it'll be interesting to see what they do moving forward.
So with the game officially being called God of War Ragnarok, I guess it doesn't take a genius to think that perhaps Ragnarok factors into this game in some manner. Can you confirm that, Eric?
Yeah, I mean, you can't call the game God of War Ragnarok and not have Ragnarok happen in the game. So,
exactly.
You know, it's going to happen. We're going to cap off the Norse series with it. And I think Chris Judge said it best in the announce trailer last year. Prepare yourselves.
The last game ended with a teaser of sorts for Thor. And I just got to know, was that Thor's voice we heard in the trailer just a few minutes ago?
That was definitely Thor's voice that we heard in the trailer. Thor is being played by Ryan Hurst, which you might know him from... Sons of Anarchy. He played Opie, one of my favorite characters ever.
No way!
Delighted to have him come play in the God of War sandbox, and his take on Thor.
He also played Data in
the
Walking Dead.
Australian, you might know. You know, he's much closer to the Norse mythology
so,
version. You know, he's this big, burly, hedonistic man-child, red
I'm
hair,
excited.
You know, left-handed. Just,
Casey
just a little
can't
off
tell.
Than the Thor that a lot of
I'm trying to keep
right
it
now,
like
so
down a little bit though, because I don't want to blow out the audio levels.
We also heard the name Odin in tonight's trailer, so I imagine if we're going to experience Ragnarok, Odin's going to have to play a pretty big role here, right?
Definitely. I mean, Odin is the Allfather of all the realms, so he's going to show up when Ragnarok happens. We're very, very happy to have Mr. Richard Schiff come on to play.
I'm just
Odin
looking
for
at the background,
so
just
Toby
getting
from
lost. From everything
that
that's there.
We never thought was going to happen. It was like kind of a shot in the dark, and he got back to us, and we walked
so
around
cool
the mocap
stuff.
Volume, and he was just like, I've never done anything like this before. Let's do it. And so...
Are you excited?
Kind of
chat,
so
let me know. Are you excited
for
the new God of War? Let me know
in
the chat.
It's a very different take, again, much like Thor. You know, he's like a old man who's just kind of busy with his own things and doing whatever he wants, and he's...
Old man Kratos.
He doesn't live in a castle or anything like that, so it's a, again, a different take, kind of what we do. We just take what's known and curveball it a little bit and, you know, make it special.
We also saw a couple of new characters tonight, so what can you tell us about them?
Are you talking about the little squid? Oh no, you're talking about Tyr. Tyr, the big guy. Yeah, yeah. He's the Norse god of war. Curtis and Trace have finally found him. We talked a lot about him in 2018, so we were like, well, we might as well show him to the people. And then the last character we saw at the trailer, you know, like with the little wink and smile from Angar Boda, she's one of the last remaining giants, and her story is pretty amazing and how it fits into the world of God of War. Tyr is being played by Ben Prendergast, who's been completely absorbed in the role, even though he is not a giant as Tyr is. Angar Boda is being played by Leia De Leon Hayes, who's a complete treasure on set. She's been amazing. Watching her chemistry with the other characters has been amazing. She's one of the last giants that's acting. Living. So we have those characters and a few more. And, you know, there's a lot of different monsters you saw in there. And it's been so many talented people at the studio building this trailer and putting it together. I just want to give a shout out to the team. I love you guys. You know, I wish you could be here doing this interview with me. I wish you were all behind me right now in the studio.
Maybe I'll do like a reel or something.
Amazing. And, you know, lastly to our fans.
See what happens.
We have a saying at the studio.
You never know, right?
We're fans of our fans. And I cannot wait to watch all the tweets, the messages, the reaction videos that you guys put out, and our team to be able to take that into heart. And just get excited and hyped, and then use that to push us through and finish the game for you guys. So thank you very much.
I'm hyped.
We haven't heard a whole lot out of you
for this game.
So now that we know you're not directing God of War Ragnarok, I was hoping maybe you could give us a little clue about what you may or may not be working on next.
Oh, you'd like that, wouldn't you? You'd like me to just spill the beans and tell you everything that's going on
right
now.
Reveal your
secrets. We're actually doing a bunch of stuff. It's really exciting, all the things that we're doing, and you're tempted to know what is this. But I don't really have anything I could talk about right now, specifically, mostly because we're really focused on God of War Ragnarok, that I am incredibly excited that I finally understand that that's what everyone was saying, God of War Ragnarok. I was way off. I was thinking it was something else that they were talking about. I think we'll wait to get any deeper into anything else until later. We'll talk again, Sid.
All right. Well, thank you, Corey, and thank you, Eric. And next up, we have Ryan Treadwell. He's the lead producer at Aspyr. And wouldn't you know, just a little while ago, we got the announcement of a remake for Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic. So,
let's
Ryan,
go.
I guess my question is this like a remaster
going.
Of the original game, or what's going on here?
It's so much more, Sid. This is a complete remake of this beloved Star Wars story. For Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic Remake, we are rebuilding from the ground up while maintaining that integrity of story and character from the original.
So Ryan, how much of a remake are we talking about here? I mean, is this updating some graphics, adding some higher resolution modes?
You know, the original Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic is a true classic and one of our favorite Star Wars stories ever. We want to honor that original story and make it as impactful for players today. In terms of the visuals, we have an opportunity to present this story with a much higher level of fidelity than was possible in the past, while making sure that we're being authentic to what players loved about that original game.
So we know Aspyr from bringing classic Star Wars games to modern consoles, but this is a much bigger project than anything the studio's tackled before. So what can you tell me about the team behind the game?
You're absolutely right. While Aspyr has enjoyed a great relationship with Lucasfilm Games through our work bringing classic Star Wars games to new audiences on modern platforms, this project is on a completely different level to anything we have done before. That's why we knew we had to assemble the right team to do this project justice. We put together a team full of industry veterans from fan-favorite RPGs, even including the original Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic. It has been a really rewarding experience to assemble such a talented team to bring back an epic game. Of course, we're also working closely with the amazing teams at PlayStation and Lucasfilm Games. Together,
so
we couldn't be more excited about
what
we'll be able
to
show you in the future.
Not.
All of us are, of course, huge Star Wars fans too. One of the nice parts about building a team to make a big Star Wars game is the ability
that would be
to
a headline
with all the new people of your favorite aspects of Star Wars. We all have different Star Wars memorabilia behind us in every call, and it always sparks up a good conversation.
All right, thanks, Ryan.
We'll have to find out, though.
Very exciting stuff.
I'm excited for it. Let me know in the chat. Are you excited?
Thank you, Sid. It will be some time before we're ready to show more, but we're very excited about being able to reveal more in the future.
All right, and that's it for our show. You can catch up on all the big news on PlayStation.blog and check out all the trailers from tonight's PlayStation Showcase on YouTube. Thanks for watching. PlayStation.
There we go, folks. Where did I go? Right here. So there you have it, folks. And that was the PlayStation Showcase. And let me tell you, I am excited. Holy cow. There we go. We'll get the Fortnite back up. Yeah, I'm excited. It's going to be a lot of fun. Wow. I don't know what else to say. If I could pick one thing from the showcase that was my favorite announcement, right here on the table, hands down, Spider-Man 2, without a doubt. Don't get me wrong, I'm excited for God of War, but Spider-Man 2, I mean, come on. If you haven't played it on PlayStation 4 or on PlayStation 5, including the new game, Miles Morales, you owe it to yourself to pick up both of those games. I got to go drink some water or something. I got to recover from this because this has been incredible. Folks, I want to thank you so much for hanging out with me today. I really appreciate it. Don't forget, you can go on Twitter, or you can follow me on Twitter, rather. I'm so excited. I can't even talk. You can follow me on Twitter and Instagram at Chris Zeiser, spelt exactly as it is on my channel. Terrence is going to be here, too. So I know everyone just shows up for Terrence. So Terrence will be here. He's not going anywhere. Take care, everyone. Thanks for watching.